Oh, hey, sorry about that, guys. I was doing the sprinkler because I'm excited because Google just dropped the bomb a couple days ago and they came out with Tour Creator, which allows students and adults to make their own virtual tours, which goes hand in hand with a lot of this virtual reality stuff that schools are dabbling in. And so I want to walk you through it. I'll show you how it works because I've been playing with it this morning and I'd like to, you know, some people would like to kind of know some tips and tricks and how to get it going. I'll take you through a tour I created. I created a very short mini tour of the place I work at. It's called Pioneer RESA in Northeast Georgia. And we're actually an old elementary school that was converted into a professional development office building. So we have some big rooms, hallways, things where people work at. Yeah, and do training. So I'll show you the one I made. So I made this one. This has three different places in it. So I made this tour and I started with something that Google had already given me, and that was called Street View. Some of you are familiar with this. If you ever do a Google map, the Google car comes down the street and it takes pictures. So I just said, you know what? I can use this. This is the front of our building and looks like someone's parked underneath the shade tree there. That was very smart. And I can keep going through, and it gives you, you know, it gives you some information about the tour. It says, I'm exploring the possibilities of Google Tour Creator by documenting spaces at Pioneer RESA. So it's very new for me, probably new for you too. But then I go to the next one. I made this next one. I went into the hallway. If you've ever been here, which many of you have never been here because you're all over the world, but we have a long hallway. I mean, a very long hallway, like a lot of schools do. And it was not perfect because I created this 360 video. By the way, it's 360. I mean, I can go all around. That's cool, right? That's cool. That's cool. And I created this 360 picture by using my phone. And I use Google's free Street View app. But when you use it, I mean, you have to take a lot of pictures. You stand in a circle. You just stand. And then you have to move around, take like, I don't know, 30 pictures. And it puts them all together. And it made this. So it wasn't perfect, but it was free. I didn't have to buy a camera, a fancy 360 camera to do this. But wow, it's pretty cool, right? And I was able to put that as part of my tour. So that was scene two. And then I'll show you scene three. Before I show you scene three, you can add, and this blew me away because I didn't know this. So on the tour, students, adults can add different little waypoints or points of information. So right here, I have a poster for Lumpkin County School System. And if you touch this while you're on the tour, it says Lumpkin County Charter System. I say it's one of our 15 member systems located in Dahlonega, Georgia. And even I tried to put a link to a YouTube video that their choir did for the Foreigner song, I Want to Know What Love Is. I want to know what love is, that song. But it would not hyperlink it. It just, you know, gave me the text. So boo, but maybe it'll get better. So there's that. Hyperlink would be cool. It would be cool. Google, you're listening. Hyperlink, cool. And so let's go to the last scene. So here's one of our rooms, our training rooms. So how cool would it be for someone who's not familiar with Pioneer RESA or what we do or what our buildings are? Say, you know what? I'm going to room B and I need to know what the layout is because, you know, I have some digestive issues and I need to make sure I can get to the back door right there by the hallway as soon as possible, you know, in case there's an emergency. So, you know, that's a weird example, but you know what I mean. And if you go over here, you can see that there's, again, it's not perfect. The pictures didn't quite, you know, match up exactly, and it gave me some distortion, but I added another information point, and it could be a picture. It's actually an overlay, right? And I said, this is our projection screen. It's distorted during the photo process, but you can, so the students can add pictures and things as part of their tour in this virtual environment. All right, 360. Look at that. That's pretty cool. So let's go make one. I want to show you how to do this. I want to show you what love is. So the first thing is you have to go to their new website, vr.google.com/tour creator. And I don't know if you can hear this, but my computer is humming right now because it's working. Now this takes a lot of processing power to do what I'm doing. I'm interested to see how this works on a Chromebook. That could be my next test because I want to make sure that before we get real crazy with this, that when you start popping up those $150, $200 Chromebooks, that the students will still have a nice time. It's not going to, your computer's not going to burst in flames because of how much work it has to do to make these things. So I'm on a 2012 MacBook Pro. So mine's about 6 years old, and it's, you know, it's starting to hum a little bit there because it's working hard. So I'll test it out later. I just want to give you a little heads up there, but it works in the Chrome browser. It should work on a Chromebook. I just want to be upfront. So once you hit get started, you get to log in to your Google account, and you will soon be in their tour creator. I'll go ahead and do mine. It's going to say redirect. It's logging me in. Cha-ching. I should be there. Voila. So there's my tour. And if you're, I mean, this is brand new. This came out 2 days ago. And this is May 11th, 2018. So this is like the night this came out. So your school technology director, admin, may not even know this is out there. And you may not be allowed to even do this yet because they don't know what it is. So if you're a teacher and you're like, man, I want to do this stuff. I want to make some tours. I get the kids excited about places. You can politely ask your tech director and say, hey, may I please have access to Tour Creator? Because there's a little checkbox, I'm sure, that they have to go, yes, this sounds like a legitimate thing for teachers to have. So you got to be buddies now. Y'all play nice together. All right, so here we are. And this is the tour I just made. I just showed you. I'm going to create a new tour. So you hit the new tour here, and you get to choose a cover photo. So I'm going to choose one. I made one, and let's see if it looks better than my last one. I'm so fancy. Look at this. That looks good. I did that in Canva, by the way. So Canva is a great place. And I did the, so if you're looking for the resolution for this picture to make that look good, I did 1,000 pixels by 500 pixels. I just did a blank slate, and then I threw some text on there and a little, you know, cardboard viewer thing. So I'm going to call this the tour guide. This is the tour guide, right? And I'm going to say just showing people how this thing works. Category can be, I don't know, probably uncategorized. But earlier I did places because a lot of businesses are using this. So churches, businesses, organizations are using this to actually create tours. Like, you know, they want to get business. They want to get people in their places. You know, students are going to build tours to enhance the things that they're learning in class, to engage them and make connection, visual connection. So there is no thing for education here, but you can do, you know, places and scenes. So I'm going to create, and let's see if it works. Oh, I'm there. It says add scene down here in the bottom. See that? Add scene. And this is where it's cool. So your students can actually just grab things from Google Maps. And I'm pretty sure they have access to things from Expeditions as well. So I'm going to put, let's say, we live in Cleveland, Georgia. I mean, that's where this place is at. Let's see if there's anything in Cleveland, Georgia. Oh, downtown Cleveland, Georgia. So here we are. I can zoom out here a little bit. So there's Cleveland, Georgia. I'm like, you know, this is cool, right? The street view. And I can add this to the scene. So down here, I say, yes, I like this. I want to add it. So click add. Now, this is my first scene, but let's give it a name. We'll call it Downtown Cleveland, Georgia. Put the address in there if I want a description. This is like historic, maybe a courthouse. I can't remember. It's right in the middle town. Credits. You can't put the credit there if you know who took the picture. But this is going to be a Google Maps type thing. So it's probably the Google car. But this is the cool part, which I didn't know. You can add a point of interest. So you click add point of interest. Let me see here. This place has great. Okay. This place down here, the soda, I think it's called the pharmacy. They have good shakes, milkshakes. So I'm going to click this button and I'm going to put this little dot over here and say, you know what? This is they call it the pharmacy. I think they still call it that. I'm going to say best milkshakes. And I can add a picture, like a big milkshake. I could put it over that building if I wanted. So that'd be kind of a fun, you know, visualization of this map. I'm not, because I don't have a picture of a milkshake, and I want to make this video as efficient as possible. But I can add more interest points, that whatever I want. So I'm good there. And I'm going to hit... So we're done with that one, actually. I mean, I can keep going. I can keep adding things. I'm done with this one. So there's downtown Cleveland, George. Let's add one more scene. Now, this is where you get the student can upload their own 360 content. And like I said, they can take iPads, they can take Android phones, Apple phones, those are called iPhones, and they can make their own 360 content for free using Google Street View. And then they could upload it here. But they also make, which I told you, it's not perfect. I mean, you got to take like 30 pictures, this work. But you can also, maybe your school can buy a 360 camera and make this process a whole lot more simple. And so Rico is a company, and they're probably the most well-known for making inexpensive 360 cameras, okay? The least expensive 360 cameras. So you could try those out. And you just buy these cameras. They go on a little stand, a little tripod, and it just takes a 360 photo. Voila. And that would bring a lot of joy to the boys and girls. So there you go. You could buy those cameras. But I'm just going to upload one of mine that I already had. Let's see. This is the one. No, that's my last one. Okay. So upload. And I think I have one. I'll do the one I did from the hallway earlier just so you show you. So all it's actually just a JPEG. You can see down here. Allowed file types is JPEG. And I created that using Google Street View, and I saved it to my phone. And then I shared it with my computer. I had to get it to my computer to really do this. So here it is. It's a JPEG. And we'll see what happens. And that's what it looks like when you have a bunch of pictures put together. That's what a 360 photo looks like. So I'm going to hit add scene. And now let's go give it a name. I'll call it the RESA hallway. I could add all the same things like I did before, but I took this picture, so I'm getting credit for this one. All right. The kids love that kind of stuff. So there's that. And I could add more scenes, point of interest. And, you know, Google did say that in their help, because I looked at the help file because I was trying to, you know, do a really good job with this video, that you can upload video with this point of interest or overlays. However, it would not let me upload video, and it's supposed to be under 2 megabytes. It would not let me do that. Maybe it's because it's brand new. They made the help file, but they didn't really unleash that feature yet. But hopefully that's coming. And here's the other big thing. Supposedly by the end of the year, that's what they said, not Brian said, that when students make their tours, that they will actually be able to work within expeditions. So all my VR friends out there who are using Google Expeditions and VR labs with students, that their student content or teacher created content will be able to work within Google Expeditions. And I love that because it's very, very simple for teachers. A teacher hits a button, everybody in the room goes to a certain place. Oh, can't wait. All right, now let's just finish up here. So you make your tour. I have, it looks like I have two different places down here, two different scenes, downtown Cleveland, RESA hallway. I can keep adding more and more places, but it's time to publish. And this is where some people get scared. They're like, wow, Brian, I don't know if I want the world to know, you know, about my kids and the things they're making. Well, if you don't want them to know about it, there's this little thing down here. It's called unlisted. And what that means is the only way other people in the world will know about these places or the things that your students made would be as if they shared it with them. Okay. So unlisted means it's the ability to be shared with anybody is still there, but it's not being broadcasted to the public. All right. So it's just unlisted. And if you publish that, let's go ahead and do that. Publish. Oh, man. Oh, and I have one more fun goodie to end with, since I know most of you are using a lot of Google apps. So there's the address. Isn't that cool? Have an address and copy that link and give it to anybody I want. Let's view the tour. There's the tour we just made. You and I, we made it together. Downtown Cleveland, and I'm going to scene two. Here's the hallway. And lastly, share. Now this is cool. So if you click share, there's the embed option. Now we're going to go full circle here. I'm going to copy the embed code because as you know, you might know that your students can make Google websites. And that's still locked down by your district. It's very safe. They don't have to, you know, show the world. But let's say I made this Google site. This is using the new Google sites, which I don't even think you can get to the old Google sites. And I just called it My Portfolio, Mapping the World. And on the insert option, there is embed right here. If I click that, embed code, paste. Remember that thing I pasted? Yeah, I did. Hit next. Let's see what happens. I think it's going to work. Oh, it's going to work. Like it's loading. I mean, this is a big deal. So here we go. I'm going to go ahead and insert it. So hit insert. There it is. We have to be patient. You know, patience is a virtue. Got to have it. And I can stretch this thing out. All right. So I'm embedding this virtual tour on my Google site so students can have ownership of the things that they're creating in your classes. All right, very good, very good. Come on, come on. Takes a lot of time to load. But let's see what this looks like. So I'm going to view publish site. Let's see if this will be on there. Hopefully it is. I may have to put publish first. There it goes. It's going to work. Look at that. It's happening. We just made a tour. We just put it on a Google site that we can now share with our class. The teacher can say, hey guys, I need to see your tour. And they all give it to the teacher via Google site and Google Classroom. Man, look at that, man. It's beautiful. Look at that. And it's good scene to scene. There you go, guys. Google's virtual tours. And it is here, right? Tour creator. You want to get on it. Go try it out. Go click around. I mean, that's what I did this morning. I just went over there and clicked around. Try it on a Chromebook. See how well it does with the Chromebook. Like I said, I'm on like a 6-year-old computer. I'm thinking it'll be fine. It's just going to take a little time for some of those things to render. So, hey, y'all reach out. Let me know if you like this. Subscribe. See you guys. Bye.